I'm by Young & Shepherd. This house has gone up by $500,000 over the past year. That's the reality of the market. Let me share with you our real estate market update here in Toronto. Hey everyone, it's Michael Dougal with eXp Realty. You'll find timestamps in the YouTube description box, and please consider subscribing if you get value from this video. I really appreciate your support. Looking at this very first chart here, where we have a breakdown month by month in 2021 of sales, the active listings, the months of inventory, the average price, and the days on market. So looking at the number of sales, we can see that it did trend upwards. January, we only had 6,900. February, 11,000, March, 15,000, and then it seemed to taper off a little bit. We only had 13,663 sales during the month of April. This is a little bit different than the years prior, as typically April has more transactions than the month of March. But taking a look at the number of active listings in April, it was at a high point of 11,668. Prior to that in March, it was 10,603. And then back in January and February, there were far less listings. And then what happened was in March and April, since more people were being vaccinated, sellers likely felt more comfortable listing their homes for sale. Looking now at the months of inventory, and this is where things get a little bit interesting, as this is a good measure of the strength of the market. The lower this number is, the more favorable it is to sellers, and conversely, the higher the number is, the better it is for buyers. So the months of inventory was 1.1 in January. It dropped down to 0.8, and then in March, which was probably the best time to sell your home, it was only at 0.7. However, in April, the months of inventory was 0.9. And the way you can arrive at that number is taking the number of active listings and divided by the sale. So what this means is there were a lot of new listings, but there weren't as many sales. And then as further evidence that March was the best time for sellers, we can see here the average price month by month. In January, it was $967,000. In February, $1,045,000. And March, we almost hit $1.1 million. It was $1,097,000. And now, just a little slight decrease to $1,091,000 during the month of April. And then looking at the DOM, which stands for days on market, this is how long it'll take a property to sell from the time that a seller starts showing the home to buy. So in January it was 24, February 14th, and March and April both had their listings at 10 days on the market before they sold. Now let's take a look at the 5-year historical average price. This goes all the way back from 2016, and we can see the average price throughout 2016 to 2021. So clearly, values have quite significantly appreciated. In 2016, the average price was only $668,000. Whereas in 2021, it's $1,037,000. So these were numbers taken from the first quarter of every year. Of course, we remember in 2017, the prices were really high compared to what they were in 2016. And then in mid-2017, when the government introduced the foreign tax that any foreign purchaser would have to pay a surplus on their property, a premium, then the prices did drop down to $763,000. And since then, it's been climbing. And now we're at a point where the market is very strong, not just for freehold detached properties, but condominiums as well. Taking a look now at the different styles of properties, we can see which type of home experienced the most appreciation or depreciation. So detached properties, as we can see, experienced the most appreciation over the past year. In 2021, the first quarter had the average price at $1,086,000. But in the first quarter of 2021, the average price was $1,378,000, which is a 27% increase year over year. Absolutely incredible. Semi-detached, the average price in 2020, the first quarter was $851,000. The first quarter of 2021 had the average price $1,031,000. That's a 21% increase. Townhouses, from $772,000 to $884,000, that's a 9.3% increase. And the condo market, that's the only style of property that has unfortunately depreciated. It was at $651,000 in the first quarter of 2020. And during the first quarter of 2021, the average price was $639,000. However, do note that there is a big difference between condos in Toronto versus condos in other areas of the GTA like Vaughan, Markham, Richmond Hill. As we can see in this breakdown here, year over year, the average condo decreased in Toronto, the 416 area, by 6.4%. But in the 905, the average condo did appreciate in value by 5.4%. And taking a look now at the quarter one total sales and average price, we can see there was a pretty significant increase in the number of transactions. So these were sales reported. In 2021, there were 19,849 sales during the first quarter. But in 2021, despite COVID and the lockdown, there were 33,550 sales, which is a 69% increase. And looking at the average price in 2020, the average price was $884,000. And in 2021, the average price was $1,037,000. And this covers all styles of properties, all areas in the greater Toronto area. That's a 17.3% increase. So it's clear that despite prices being high, there is certainly demand. Maybe that's due to the low cost of borrowing money at this time, but we are seeing a slight transition in the marketplace. Like I mentioned, March was better than April in terms of the average price and days on market. Trust that you're always going to hear information here first. You will often hear stuff reported on the news or the Toronto Star, but that's several weeks afterwards, and by then sometimes you may have not been able to capitalize on the market. So do consider subscribing and click the bell icon so that you're notified when there's new videos. So I really appreciate your support. If you're an ambitious real estate agent and you'd like to connect, then do contact me. My contact information is in the description box below, and I will look forward to seeing you all next time.